While there are encouraging reports of economic growth in some countries, as well as peaceful elections in others, most of these positive developments were overshadowed by the worst ever Ebola epidemic in the three West African countries. Now, the main issue of the Nigerian terrorist group Boko Haram, militant attacks in Kenya and Somalia, instability in the Central African Republic, and internal fighting in South Sudan, which has created a humanitarian crisis in the region.
We have already 250,000 refugees that were in exile for 20 years, came back, and are again in Uganda, in Kenya, in Ethiopia, and in Sudan. If peace does not come soon, we risk that they lose hope, and we risk this country to see its future entirely compromised.
Well, now for a quick review of some of the events that made the headlines, I'm joined by Nyaka Lagoke, is a professor and analyst of African issues. Nyaka, welcome to Africa 54.
Hi, thank you very much.
Now, as you mentioned there, you know, the year started almost well, then suddenly we started hearing story of Ebola spreading across the continent. What would you say this has done to the continent throughout the year, Ebola?
What can you
Ebola
say?
Ebola, specifically.
No, Ebola damaged, you know, the image as Africa was recovering, you know, from bad publicity. And all of a sudden, after the summit between the U.S. president and the African leaders, and then we heard about Ebola, it was a damaging stuff. And I think that Africans should take the opportunity to try and see how they can together solve their issues, be Ebola, HIV, or any other, or malaria.
And this is not so much of just an image, but also there were economic implications.
And of course, you know, everyone has been talking about that. Economic implications and the loss of lives. 10,000 people already dead, so it's a lot.
It's terrible. Okay. But not too far from the three affected countries, we are still talking about the missing girls of Chibok in Nigeria. What do you make of what has been going on throughout the year in that part of the country?
Oh, it's an hallmark of how African leaders deal with issues, even in time of peace. You know, many of them, you know, cannot deliver. It's not going to be in a time of crisis when the ladies are taken that because Jonathan Goodluck has been, according to many Nigerians, is an ineffective and inefficient president. So this is what I can say about the story of those ladies.
Yes. Moving away from the terrorist attacks, but we also had a few countries of the continent where we never thought anything's going to happen, and then suddenly, boom. There was the Central African Republic.
Oh, yes. A weak body. We saw it coming.
Yeah.
We saw it coming. Between the, you know, we saw that, you know, the way Bozize was ruling, we knew that sooner or later, people will come, organize, take weapons and come and try to bring, like, civil war to the Central African Republic.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, for some, actually, one of the saddest events in terms of both instability and also humanitarian situation is South Sudan. New nation, you are very hopeful. You're a Pan-Africanist.
No, but we never spoke about South Sudan. But the way South Sudan became independent and the way the American officials dealt with South Sudan, you know, we could see.
Because, what was wrong with it?
Oh, no, because in the beginning, it looks like they did not have the right to even they have some security issues, and they did not receive the support, even though people knew that, you know, they broke away from North Sudan. First and second, internal conflict and tribalism and a fight for power, you know, the same ingredients, you know, that make African countries implode were there. Then we should not be surprised to see that. And quickly, I think that one of the things I wanted to mention is Scott, yeah.
First white president
in Democratic Africa.
Yeah.
I think that was a good year in Zambia
after the death
of Michael Starter. So that was something that, yes.
Yeah, that's another, we can say, a positive story.
Yeah, that's
Zambia
a positive story.
Zambia has experienced a few misfortunes, mm-hmm. presidents dying, but mm-hmm. we have progressively noticed that there is peaceful transition.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
So what's your hope for the coming year?
For Africa, Africa, I see that we're going to see an effect of the Burkinabe revolution mm-hmm. that ousted Blaise Compaoré. We're going to see that impact on different countries. Togo, we saw already that the president of Benin said that he's not going to change the constitution. And this is one thing. we see, second, that there is a new trend in Africa that people are fighting for economic freedom with Malema in South Africa. And now we have the same movement that was created in Namibia.
Yeah.
We have economic freedom fighters in South Africa,
yeah.
in Namibia, for wealth distribution. I think this is the trend, and Pan-Africanism is gaining a new momentum. Okay.
You know, this is a conversation we have to continue at another time.
Okay.
Nyaka,
thank you very much
for sharing your perspectives with us. Well, Nyaka Lagoke is a professor and analyst of African affairs. Thank you.